Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of gold leaf on leather. I provided two images that you could download. One is this leather texture, and the other is this high contrast black and white graphic. Their links are in my video's description or project files. Feel free to use another black and white graphic if you like. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click that like button, which lets YouTube know you like my stuff. First, we'll place the graphic onto the leather texture. With your Move tool active, drag it onto the tab of the leather. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold the Shift key as you drag it down and release. Pressing Shift kept the graphic centered over the leather document. To ensure that your graphic is pure black and white, go to Image and Auto Contrast. This darkens the darkest pixels to pure black and lightens the lightest pixels to pure white. To resize your graphic, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner. If you're using CC 2019 or later, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it out or in. If you're using an earlier version, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it. Make it approximately this size, since we'll be needing this much of the leather surrounding it after we angle it in perspective later. To accept it, press Enter or Return. Next, we'll create a displacement map of the leather texture that we'll use to make our graphic look as if it's conforming to the contours of the leather. Temporarily hide the graphic and make the leather active. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J, and remove its color by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift U. We'll brighten it by pressing Ctrl or Command L to open levels. Drag the input highlights anywhere between 90 and 100. Since displacement maps look best when they're slightly blurred, go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 2 pixels. In the Layers panel, open the Flyout list and click Duplicate Layer. Open the Destination Document list and click New. Name it Displacement. Notice it created a new document, which we'll save. Go to File. If you're using CC 2021 or later, click Save a Copy. If you're using an earlier version, click Save As. Save it to your desktop for easy access as a Photoshop PSD file. Then click Save. If you see this message, just click OK. Now we can close the displacement file. When you see this message, click No. Delete the background copy since we don't need it anymore. Press the Delete key. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Check your foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. We'll invert the colors by pressing X or by clicking this icon. Click the foreground color to open the color picker, and in the hexadecimal field, type in B27D29. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Notice our foreground color is now the color we just typed in. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Distort folder and click Glass. Make the distortion 18, the smoothness 4, the texture frosted, and the scaling 200%. Alt or Option click the eyeball icon next to the graphic, which makes it the only visible layer. Make the graphic active and open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control or Command click any of the channels to select the shapes of our graphic. Press the Delete key to delete the white background behind it. Deselect it by pressing Control or Command D. Invert the graphic to white by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Convert it into a smart object and go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. Displace it 2 pixels, which is just enough to contour our graphic to the leather texture. Tick Stretch to Fit and repeat Edge Pixels. Click the Displacement PSD file you saved earlier and click Open. Let's collapse the smart filters to save some space in the Layers panel. Make the other 2 layers visible, and with the graphic still active, change its blend mode to Overlay. Control or Command-click the thumbnail of the graphic to select its shape. Shift-click the gold leaf texture to make it active as well, and press Control or Command-G to place the 2 layers into a folder. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the folder. The white shape of the layer mask is revealing the contents of the folder onto the leather background under it. Shift-click the leather texture to make it active as well, and convert the 2 layers into a smart object. Make a copy of it, and open your pen tool. Click approximately here, release, and click approximately here to create your first path. Continue this to create paths that approximate this shape and size. Complete the path by clicking back on your first anchor point. Right-click or secondary-click directly on the path to open the flyout list and click Make Selection. Feather the radius 100 pixels. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Curves. We want the adjustment layer to affect just the 1 layer beneath it. However, since adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel, we'll need to clip it or restrict it to the 1 layer below it. To do this, click the Clipping Mask icon or go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. Place your cursor on the middle of the grid and drag it up and over to approximately here to brighten the midtones of our image. Make the bottom layer active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Curves again. Go to the center and drag the diagonal line to approximately here to darken the midtones of our image. Next, we'll resize, angle, and rotate it. Click the Curves adjustment layer to make it active and make a new layer above it. In this layer, we'll make a composite snapshot. Press Ctrl-Alt-Shift-E on Windows or Command-Option-Shift-E on a Mac. Open your Transform tool and press Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard a few times to zoom out. Go to a bottom corner and press and hold Ctrl-Alt-Shift on Windows or Option-Command-Shift on a Mac as you drag it out. Go to a top corner and press and hold Alt or Option on later versions or Alt or Option plus Shift on earlier versions as you drag it out. To rotate it, hover your cursor near a corner and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it to an angle you like. To fit it onto your screen, press Ctrl or Command 0. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.